2. Topic: Government policies and interventions for development in various sectors and issues arising out of their design and implementation. Sivya Bhajay Yajna. What to study? For prelims, Sivya Bhajay Yajna. Features. For mains, GST and its implications, issues associated and reforms to resolve them. Context: Union Ministry of Culture has launched Sivya Bhajay Yajna, the scheme to reimburse central share of CGST and IGST on food, prasad, langar or bandaran offered by religious and charitable institutions. The Sivya Bhajay Yajna has a total outlay of Rs 325.00 crore for financial years 2018 to 19 and 2019 to 20. About Sivya Bhajay Yajna. The scheme seeks to reimburse the central government's share of central goods and services tax CGST and integrated goods and service tax IGST on purchase of raw items such as ghee, vegetable oil, fatted, maida, raw malt, flour, rice pulses, sugar and jaggery, which go into preparation of food / prasad / langar / bandaran offered free of cost by religious institutions. The main objective of the scheme is to lessen the financial burden of such charitable religious institutions, which provide free of cost without any discrimination to the general public and devotees. Eligibility. The charitable religious institutions including temples, gurdwara, mosque, church, durgashram, dargah, monasteries, which fulfill the following criteria are eligible for the grant. The institutions that have been in existence for at least 5 years before applying for financial assistance / grant. The institutions that serve free food to at least 5,000 people in a month. The institutions covered under Section 1023 BEA of the Income Tax Act for those registered as society under Societies Registration Act XXI of 1864 as a public trust under any law for the time being in force of statutory religious bodies constituted under any at poor institutions registered. Under Section 12AA of Income Tax Act. Sources: The Hindu. Topic: Government policies and interventions for development in various sectors and issues arising out of their design and implementation. Concessional Financing Scheme CFS. What to study? For prelims, CFS. Features. For mains, significance of the scheme. Context: The Union Cabinet has approved the first extension of Concessional Financing Scheme CFS to support Indian entities bidding for strategically important infrastructure projects abroad. Under the CFS, the GOBD of India has been supporting Indian entities bidding for strategically important infrastructure projects abroad since 2015-16. How CFS works? Under the scheme, India selects the specific projects keeping in view strategic interest of India and sends the same to Department of Economic Affairs, DEA. The strategic importance of a project to deserve financing under this scheme is decided on a case-to-case basis by a committee chaired by Secretary, DEA. Once approved by the committee, DEA issues a formal letter to Exim Bank conveying approval for financing of the project under CFS. The scheme is presently being operated through the Export-Import Bank of India, which raises resources from the market to provide concessional finance. Government of India provides counter guarantee and interest equalization support of 2% to the Exim Bank. Under the scheme, Exim Bank extends credit at a rate not exceeding Libor average of 6 months plus 100 BPS. The repayment of the loan is guaranteed by the foreign GOBD. Significance of the scheme. Prior to the introduction of CFS, Indian entities were not able to bid for large projects abroad since the cost of financing was very high for them and bidders from other countries such as China, Japan, Europe and US were able to provide credit at superior terms, i.e., lower interest rate and longer tenures, which works to the advantage of bidders from those countries. Also, by having projects of strategic interest to India executed by Indian entities, the CFS enables India to generate substantial backward linkage-induced jobs, demand for material and machinery in India, and also a lot of good